Hi, welcome to the virtual classroom. My name is Fahad Ali Khan. In this video, I'll solve a question from first year mathematics, chapter number 3, exercise 3.4. Now, whenever you are given an equation like this, then you have to make sure that when you multiply the brackets in pair, then the term in x square and x must be the same. What exactly do I mean? Just have a look. I just rearranged these four brackets in such a way that when I multiply this x plus 6 and x minus 2, I get x square plus 4x minus 12. Similarly, when I simplify x plus 1 and x plus 3, after rearranging, I get x square plus 4x plus 3. Now, this x square plus 4x is identical in both the brackets. And this is how I can go for the substitution. Now, I suppose this x square plus 4x equals to y, and I can term this as I consider this as equation number 1. When I substitute back this value of x square plus 4x, instead of x square plus 4x, when I put this as y in above equation, I get y minus 12 and y plus 3 at 56 equals 0. Through further multiplication, I develop a quadratic equation y square minus 9y plus 20 equals 0, and through any of the method, by factorization, by quadratic formula, or by completing the square method, I can get the value of y, which is 4 and 5 in this case. Now, this is not my answer actually. I'm looking for the answer in x, as I have already supposed an equation, that is equation 1. So I can put these values of y, 4 and 5, back in equation 1 to get the values of x. Now, substituting the values of y in equation 1, when y equals 4, I put this value back over here, so I get x squared plus 4x equals to 4. Adding negative 4 to both sides, I develop this equation, x squared plus 4x minus 4 equals 0. Now, I would try to save some space. So, straight away using this quadratic formula, as we know, we get this answer, minus 2 plus minus 2 square root 2. Similarly, when I put this value of y equals 5 in above equation, in this equation number 1, I get x squared plus 4x equals 5, and by adding negative 5 to both sides, I get this x squared plus 4x minus 5 equals 0, and through factorization, I get the values of x, which is minus 5 and 1. Now, finally, I've got four answers. Two of the answers are minus 2 plus minus 2 root 2, 2 square root 2, and two of them are minus 5 and 1, which can be written in this particular form, like in solution set form, and that's my final answer. I hope this will work for you. If you find this useful, please do share. Keep watching my video, subscribe to my channel. Thank you.